Hello and welcome back to the channel Englishpedia by SR. I welcome all of you in this channel. Those who are watching me for the first time, hello, I'm Sangeeta Rakshit, Assistant Professor, Department of English, Chittaranjan College, Kolkata. Today's video is again on rhetoric or figures of speech, and this time we will discuss about antithesis, epigram and paradox. I have already discussed about climax, anticlimax and oxymoron, the links to which will be given in the description box. Do check them out. If you like today's video, then like this video, share it with your friends and family and subscribe to the channel for more such academic content. So without much further delay, let's begin. Let us start our discussion with antithesis. What is antithesis? This figure of speech is based on the principle of opposition or contrast. Here we will find contrasted ideas or words that are placed together for the sake of balance and emphasis at the same time. Let's see how Scott defines this figure. Scott says that antithesis is about the choice or arrangements of words to emphasize the contrast and give the effect of balance. So how you can differentiate antithesis from oxymoron? In oxymoron, the contrasted ideas will sit side by side. They are juxtaposed. But in antithesis, not necessarily the contrasted ideas or words will sit together or side by side. Let us look at a few examples now. Example number one. Better to reign in hell than to serve in heaven. In this sentence, reigning in hell is contrasted with serving in heaven. So there are two contrasted ideas set together in one sentence. Again, if you look at word-wise, reigning is opposite to serving and hell is opposite to heaven. So there is a perfect balance, although there are opposition in terms of ideas and words. So this sentence is an example of antithesis, or you can call it an antithetical statement. Example number two. To do a great right, do a little wrong. Here also, doing great right and a little wrong are contrasted ideas. Again, if you look at the words, great is contrasted to little and right to wrong. Therefore, this is again a case of antithesis, or this is an antithetical statement where contrasted ideas are set together to create an emphasis, and that too with a perfect balance. Let us now look at example number three. To err is human, to forgive divine. So there is again an opposition or contrast in terms of ideas. Also, there is contrast in terms of words. If we go by word-wise, err is opposite to forgive and human to divine. Again, idea-wise, there is a contrast too. So there is a perfect balance in the sentence, and yet there is an emphasis on the ideas. Therefore, this is an antithetical statement, or you can say the figure of speech involved here is antithesis. Example number four. Marriage has many pains, but celibacy has no pleasures. Here also, marriage is contrasted to celibacy and pains to pleasures, many to no. So there are three words which have their opposites in one sentence. Idea-wise also, there is a contrast. So therefore, this is again an antithetical statement where there is a perfect balance between the two sections or between the two contrasted ideas, yet there is one emphasis. So therefore, this is an antithetical statement. Example number five. Again, this is a very common and well-known proverb. United we stand, divided we fall. So united is contrasted to divided and stand to fall. Again, if you look at the idea, standing unitedly is contrasted with falling in a divided manner. So therefore, again, this is an antithetical statement where the contrasted ideas or words are set together with a balance to create an emphasis. Here are some more examples of antithetical statements or antithesis. Number 6, the old contemplate, the young act. Old is opposed to young and contemplate to act. Example number 7, man proposes, God disposes. So idea-wise also, there is a contrast, and word-wise also, man is opposite to God and propose to dispose. Example number 8, it is a blessing and not a curse. So blessing again is contrasted to curse. Number 9, art is long, life is short. So idea-wise, the permanency of art and transience of life is emphasized here. Word-wise, art is opposed to life and long is contrasted to short. And the last example of antithesis, a friend exaggerates a man's virtue, an enemy his crimes. So idea-wise, a friend will always manifold your virtue while your enemy will manifold your crimes. So friend is opposed to enemy and virtue to crimes. I hope the idea of antithesis is clear now. After our discussion on antithesis, let us now move on to the discussion of epigram. Like oxymoron and antithesis, epigram is also based on the principle of contrast or difference. But unlike oxymoron and antithesis, in epigram, there is a shocking contradiction in the apparent meaning of an expression or statement. If you are following the video till now, we were talking about a balance when we were discussing about antithesis. That balance is not visible in terms of epigrammatic statements. Rather, epigrammatic statement shocks us, makes us think over the witty statement again and again. Epigrammatic statements are generally witty, sharp, and brief, and it can be complimentary, satiric, aphoristic, and proverbial in nature. The basic of any epigrammatic statement is the wit within it. Let us now look at what our great masters in terms of literature and rhetoric have to say about epigram. S.T. Coleridge explains it in the following way. What is an epigram? A dwarfish whole, its body brevity, and wit its soul. So it will be dwarfish in nature. That means it will be short. Brevity is the shortness. And the basic idea is the wit. Wit is its soul. Again, Martial, the famous Latin epigrammatist, defines epigram in this way. Three things must epigrams, like bees, have all: their sting, their honey, and their body small. So here Martial is comparing epigrams with bees. And what does a bee have? Sting, honey, and small body. Sting is the wittiness of the statement. Honey is the beauty of that witty statement. And small body defines the brevity or precision of the epigrammatic statement. Let us now look at a few examples of epigrams in literature. Example number 1. There is a pleasure in poetic pains. If you read this statement at one go, you will be shocked. How come pains be pleasurable to anyone? But here, if you take pains and you create something poetic, it will give you immense pleasure. So idea-wise, there is a contrast, but this is a witty statement and a shocking one for the readers. So there is epigram in this sentence. Example number 2. To enjoy freedom, there must be utmost restraint. Again, freedom and restraint are opposite in nature, and you will think that how, if you have restraint, you can enjoy freedom. So there is again a witty statement. It makes you think, it makes you ponder over the statement again and again, and therefore it is epigram. Example number 3, the child is the father of man. Child and father again are two opposite words and ideas, and again it will make you think, how come a child be a father of man? It makes you think about the wittiness of the statement and the truth that it unfolds. Example number 4. The busiest man has the amplest pleasure. Busiest and amplest again are contradictory ideas, and again you will think, how come a busy man will have pleasure, and that too ample in nature. It will make you think, it will shock the readers, but again is based on the idea of contrast or difference. Example number 5. The king is dead, long live the king. Again, a very famous proverb heard in UK. Dead and live is again contradictory ideas. Again, it unfolds, this witty statement unfolds a truth. Let us now look at few more examples. Example number 6. Cowards die many times before death. Again, it will shock you, as death is a one-time phenomenon and dying many times is a contrasted or opposite idea. But it will make you think over this witty statement that if you want to die, die courageously, because cowards die many times before the actual death. So it is epigrammatic in nature. Example number 7. In the midst of life, we are in death. Again, an epigrammatic statement which shocks the readers, which makes you think, and again is based on the idea of contrast or difference. Example number 8. Failures are pillars of success. Again, a very famous statement. Probably you have heard this statement from your teachers, your parents a number of times. Failures will make you more successful because you will learn lessons, probably life lessons, from your failures. So therefore, failures and success are contrasted ideas, and it will make you think the universal truth that this statement unfolds. Example number 9. Speech was given to conceal his thoughts. Speech and thoughts are again contradictory ideas, contrasted ideas, and therefore it is epigrammatic in nature because it will make you think there is a shocking contradiction in terms of the meaning. Example number 10 and the last one. Beware the fury of a patient man. A patient man is never supposed to be a furious one. But again, this will make you think that if you try out a patient man again and again, it might make him furious. So there is a universal truth behind this witty statement, but this statement is based on the idea of contrast. So therefore, the figure of speech involved here is epigram. Let's now move on to another figure of speech, and that is paradox. What is a paradox or paradoxical statement? There is no such major difference superficially between epigram and paradox. Professor Bain identifies epigram with paradox. According to him, there is no major difference. Paradox, therefore, is contrary to received opinion. According to Martin, a paradox is an apparent contradiction. At first reading, it may seem absurd or impossible, but on examination, it is found to express in a memorable way a truth. It is the very essence of epigram as well. Epigram is also based on contrast, and it unfolds an universal truth. So paradox is similar to that. Let us now look at a few examples of paradox. Example number 1. Sweet are the uses of adversity. Very famous line from Shakespeare. So you will find a contradictory idea. How come adversities be sweet? It is epigrammatic as well. So if you analyze this statement from the point of view of epigram, you will be right too. So therefore, there is no such difference between paradox and epigram. All paradoxical statements are epigrammatic in nature and vice versa. Example number 2. Love's quarrel is the renewal of love. Again, a very contrasting idea. And you will think that how a quarrel between lovers lead to the renewal of love between them. Example number 3. Silence is sometimes more eloquent than words. Again, contrasting idea, and is shocking you or shocking the readers, and the readers will think over it again and again to understand the underlying truth. Example number 4. The golden rule is that there is no golden rule. Again, a very, very self-contradictory idea, and again, it is opposite to received opinion. All paradoxical statements are absurd on the very first reading. But if you read them again and again, analyze it, either from the point of view of epigram or paradox, it will give you certain universal truth. Last example, there is no one so poor as a wealthy miser. So poor and wealthy, again contrasting words, and again gives you a very well-known underlying truth that if you are wealthy and if you are a miser, a poor is better than you. So again, these are the examples of paradox, but if you analyze them from the point of view of epigram, there is no harm in it. We have discussed 3 figures of speech that are antithesis, epigram and paradox, and here you will see on screen 5 sentences from where you have to identify the involved figure of speech. Either it will be antithesis, paradox or epigram. So you need to give me the answers in the comment box, and also if you have any suggestions, if you have any video recommendation, you can also let me know in the comment section. I will see you super soon in another video. Till then, take care and happy learning.